Happy Halloween, everyone! Today I'm going to be showing you how I make Harry Potter butter beer. There are quite a few recipes with cream soda and whipped cream and butterscotch syrup, I believe, but I don't like those very much, and I think that this creamy, milk-based, spice-infused butter beer recipe that I kind of created from a few different recipes is really good. So I'm going to show you how to do that. We're going to need our butter, vanilla, brown sugar, and just a spot of baking soda to make some caramel. Then we'll need milk, coffee creamer flavored with vanilla, toffee, and caramel, of course. Nutmeg, cinnamon, whole cloves, because we're going to fish them out at the end. And then quite a bit of liquor. So I've got vanilla vodka and some butterscotch liqueur. And we're going to start with our big pot. We're going to turn it on to like a medium setting because we're going to start making our caramel. Start by melting 1 cup of butter over medium heat. And you want to melt it nice and slowly so that it doesn't brown. We are not wanting brown butter. Brown butter takes on a savory flavor, and that's not what we're looking for in this recipe. Add in 1 cup of brown sugar. You always want to pack your brown sugar in. Never measure your brown sugar as a loose cup of brown sugar because it'll be way less than you actually need. Okay, so we're gonna mix that in, and it's going to melt, and that is what is gonna help it to start caramelizing and turning into actual factual caramel. You're gonna wanna stir it quite a bit so that it continues to be incorporated, and we're wanting to bring it up to a nice boil. And once it's legitimately boiling, it's just bubbling now, we're wanting it to actually boil. Once that happens, we're gonna let it boil for 5 minutes. And while we do that, we're going to start heating up some of our milk in a separate saucepan. Because we don't want to put cold milk into hot caramel, because it will make the caramel immediately solidify. And then that will cause it to get like really, really hard. And then you'll have to stand there forever until your milk heats back up to redissolve the caramel. It was a mistake I made. It was disastrous. Alright, so milk is warming up. I did about 2 liters of it because I don't know how much I'm wanting to make. And also I'm wanting to make some with alcohol and some without because not everyone in our party drinks, and that is perfectly fine, and I'm wanting to accommodate that. Our caramel over here is boiling nicely. You can see that it's all incorporated and it has become very bubbly and very candy-like. 4 minutes in, I've set a timer for only 4 minutes. 4 minutes in, we're going to add our vanilla and then let it stir that and then let it boil for 1 more minute. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. Give that a stir. It smells delicious, by the way. Like, exactly like caramel is supposed to. You can also see that it's gotten kind of sticky. It's perfect. So we let it sit for 1 more minute, and then we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. This is important. It's going to aerate the caramel by giving it, by causing a chemical reaction, and that'll make it smoother and less likely to harden up. Makes it just better. Yeah. Remember to stir your milk throughout this process because it's going to be hot on the bottom, but not hot on the top. You want to make sure that it doesn't scald and that the top isn't cold. So make sure that it's warming up evenly. We're going to add our 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. It's going to react, so we're going to need to stir it real quickly. Ready for this? Okay, there you go. So it's starting to smell very done, so I'm actually going to remove it from the heat real quick. Just pop it over here to this other side. Continue stirring. All right, there we go. And we've got some beautiful caramel. Now, we're going to take our hot milk. We want to incorporate the milk to the caramel slowly. The milk is hot. You can see now it's bubbly. So I'm just going to do it like a cup at a time. And just Okay, so the caramel's too hot. You can see that it's bubbling too much. So we're just gonna let the caramel cool down a little bit further before we continue. So I let the caramel cool down just a little bit. You don't want it to be too cold, or else it doesn't blend with the milk. So our milk is steaming, as you can see, and so I've just been adding it in a little bit at a time, and it seems as though it is good to go. So I am going to return this pot to the heat and pour the rest of this milk into the pot, nice and slowly still. And then it'll start to blend together really nicely, and then we're going to start putting our spices in there for a really nice infusion. Put your pot on the lowest heat setting that you can, and just continue to give it a stir every now and then. It should be this beautiful butterscotch color. It's very creamy and sweet. Tastes great just how it is, but it's just sugar and milk at this point. So we're going to need to add some spices. Now we're going to be using nutmeg and cinnamon, ground cinnamon and ground nutmeg, which means these are going to stay in our drink. So there's a special way that I'm going to show you how to incorporate those so that they're not clumpy. That was the mistake I made at the beginning. Now the cloves are actually whole cloves, and we're going to fish them out at the end. So we're just going to let them go in basically just on their own as is, and then we've strained them out at the very end. So I've got, you know, half a dozen, probably more like 9 cloves. You're just going to put them right in, just as is. And as the mixture warms up, the flavor of the cloves will incorporate with the milk and sugar, and it will have a lovely, deep, spicy flavor, and at the end we can pull them out. We're also going to add 1 cup of the vanilla toffee coffee creamer, because it's very thick and creamy, and also gives us some added flavor that will help with to mask, because it's a lot of milk, so you're not wanting it to just taste like sugar and milk, you're wanting it to have that like brown toffee flavor. Using our coffee creamer, we are going to mix our spices and in a little shot glass beforehand using this tiny little spoon. Now this is important because basically it keeps your spices from becoming clumpy ahead of time. So we're going to put about a teaspoon of cinnamon and a teaspoon of nutmeg right into this shot glass. Okay, so I'm hoping you can see that, but I've got the cinnamon and nutmeg in there. Now you're just going to pour the teeniest bit of the creamer and immediately stir. What we're wanting to do is we're wanting to make a paste. And because we're using small amounts, we can make that paste a whole lot easier than trying to incorporate, because you can see even with that, it's gone kind of clumpy. Well, that's fine, because we only have a teeny amount, focus, we only have a very small amount, and so we can continue to just add liquid and kind of grind it up against itself, almost like a mortar and pestle, and we're going to make a paste, and then that paste, see, it's already easier, will be much easier to incorporate into our big pot of butter beer. So I continue adding creamer and stirring it around until I have this beautiful thin paste that is much easier to incorporate into this large pot so we don't get those clumps. All right, add your shot of spices. Okay, there we go. And give it a stir, and then we're gonna let that simmer for a couple hours at least, because we want that to be really beautifully spiced up and sweet and creamy. And then we're going to separate some out for our non-alcoholic friends, and then we are going to add our liqueur over there. So I just tasted it and it's really good, but it's a little buttery, so I'm actually going to add a little bit more milk, and that will help to absorb some of those oils and balance it out a little bit. We can always add more spices later. Just continue to let it simmer and taste and spice and adjust as you go. Okay, so I'm gonna set timers for about every half hour, so at 4 o'clock I'll check back in and give it another taste.